In the early 1990s, Plan Vivo pioneered a mechanism to enable rural communities to take action on climate change. Through the collective action of over 10,000 smallholders and community groups, Plan Vivo projects will reduce over 1.7 million tons of carbon dioxide, improve livelihoods, and protect valuable ecosystems. 20 years on, Plan Vivo is continuing to innovate.
We work with local communities in southwest Madagascar on blue carbon projects. So blue carbon is the carbon sequestered or locked up in mangrove forests. So we'll try and help communities to stop cutting down mangroves by supporting community-based associations to set up protected areas within the mangroves. Blue carbon is an exciting new opportunity for funding community-based management of mangrove forests and mangrove fisheries. The Plan Vivo accreditation system allows communities to receive the input, the financing that they need to set up these areas.
We're always investigating and researching alternative ways of what we can do with this. And so we've been looking at the use of biochar. Now, biochar is really just charcoal, but charcoal that's used as a soil amendment. What we're going to be exploring in the next several years is whether we can quantify how adding biochar to the soil can reduce the need for chemical fertilizers.
The latest standard, launched in 2013, opens up new and innovative ways for communities to access ecosystem finance.
Plan Vivo emerged with a vision to connect communities to the carbon markets. But we feel that there are opportunities being talked about in other ecosystem service markets.
This is a new market that is developing. So it is really being developed by people who are creating this market, like the coffee example we saw yesterday.
By involving coffee growers in reforestation, each pack of climate change coffee is carbon balanced. But it's not just about carbon.
We are losing the world's forest at an alarming rate. And so they're effectively creating a buffer zone. So this buffer zone is going to protect, you know, 2,000 plant species, 5,500 animal species.
If you want to get a downstream user to pay, then you have to demonstrate a downstream benefit.
Himalayan Community Carbon Project really focuses on the Himalayan watershed, which is very crucial to South Asia because it regulates the flow of water and soil downstream.
Started as a red project, rapid deforestation. Communities are starting to reverse that trend. But when 3 weeks ago when I was there, we were meeting with the state government, they're very concerned about the water supply to the state capital. And there's a reservoir that happens to be right in the middle of the project area. And it's the sedimentation rates are very high, so they're losing capacity quickly and they don't know what to do. But the issue is, what is the mechanism?
The Plan Vivo standard provides a flexible framework for approaches that protect and enhance multiple ecosystem services.